All right, here we are, back in the shop. It is now Monday. Hopefully, most of you looked at the first video I sent you. This is going to continue on from there. Okay? So, I damaged it. Sheetrock is very, very easily damaged. Doesn't take much. Now, I threw the ball pretty hard. One stuck, one went through. This is a repair that you really can't do by just putting paper over it. And I'm going to show you how to do that later. The reason this drywall repair part of the class is somewhat important to you because at some point you're going to need this. Some of you right now are freshmen and sophomores, juniors, you're going to be living at home for a while, but a lot of your seniors are going to be going off to college. Now, the college dorms today, if you're going to a newer dorm, are made like this. They're drywall. They're very, very soft, very easily damaged, and also very easily repaired. And if you know how to repair this, it'll enable you to get your deposit back because that's one of the things you're going to have to do. Whether you're moving into a dorm or you're moving into an apartment, at some point you're going to have to give some kind of security so that if you do incur some damage in the unit that you're in, when you move out, the landlord or the owner has some means of paying for it rather than being, having to find money to pay for it. They have your money that they're holding so that they can use it to pay for it. Now, again, that's not really the case now. Even going off to college, some of your dorms, if you're going to older schools, are going to be concrete, so you might not be able, it might not happen. But it is possible. And if you, again, as I said, if you incur some damage in a drywall unit, you'll be able to fix it and then, again, get your security deposit back. So, again, units like a rental, an apartment somewhere in some city someplace, you might have to give up to 2 months security in advance, which could be thousands and thousands of dollars that it would be nice to get back. Because as I'm going to show you, this repair can be done with probably a maximum, even if you bought all the tools that you needed, a maximum of $35, and you could be done, fix the hole, and then put some paint on it and walk away. But if you don't know how, then you got to pay somebody. And if I was to go into a house, now I'm very reasonable as compared to a lot of contractors, but if I was going into a house and do this, this would probably be $150, $200 fix. Some contractors would charge up to $300 or even $350 to make that repair. And again, me, I have all the stuff laying around. I've always had access to broken pieces of sheetrock and little scraps of wood, so it's going to be absolutely no overhead for me. I have stuff laying around that I can use, okay? For you that might not have any, you are going to need to acquire some stuff, and that's what I'm going to show you here now, and then on the next video we'll talk about how to fix that, okay? So I got to stop now because my phone turns off all the time. It's good to see you. Things are getting better. Hold on. Okay. I have to make short segments because I send the little videos to my daughter. She edits them, sends it back, and if I have a 10-minute video, it takes hours to send. So, at any rate, you're going to need to acquire some tools. Now, if you don't have them, you can kind of make do because as you're going to see, cutting sheetrock is very, very simple. It's very easy. I'm sure you all know what this is. Right? That is not a box cutter. It is a utility knife. They're very sharp. And the beauty about this is, I'm going to put my glasses on because safety first, right? The beauty of drywall is it's very easily cut. Now, if you only have this, you can do this whole repair. It just might take you a while. So I'm going to show you how to do it with a keyhole saw, which expedites things a little bit. But if you only have a utility knife or even a sharp knife of some sort, you can make this repair. A serrated knife would probably work better. Again, I don't want you borrowing your parents' best knives to come to start cutting sheetrock. But if you had a serrated knife, it'd be very easy to do this, okay? And here's how sheetrock cuts. It's very easy. Again, away from your fingers, make one little cut. You'll score the paper on one side. It'll very easily bend back. And then you score the paper on the other side. And it separates. Doesn't matter if you're doing a little piece like this or all the whole length of a piece. That's how it's done. It's very, very simple to do, okay? So you're gonna need some means of cutting the sheetrock. You're also gonna need, to begin with, you're gonna need a piece of sheetrock, okay? That piece right behind me, that's a full sheet. That's a 4x8 sheet. Those go for about $12. If you have no other means, you're gonna have to buy that piece. But normally, if you go to Home Depot or Lowe's, not so much the big box, I mean the little box stores, the local places, there's something different about that. But if you go to Home Depot, they'll sell you a 2-foot by 2-foot piece, but it's not very economical. That piece is about $5, but you are paying for the convenience of walking out of the store with that piece under your arm and having a little piece to work with. Okay, so you need a knife, something to cut it with, you need a piece of sheetrock, you need a Phillips head screwdriver, and you need some screws, okay? This particular repair, and this is just the way I do it, I'm sure there's many other contractors that have different ways to do it, but you'll need some small drywall screws in order to complete this repair, okay? So those are the things you need to have in order to do this, and oh, one more thing, is you need a pencil. Now, I'm gonna show you how to use this, which is a keyhole saw, which is very easily gonna dive into the sheetrock, and I'll be able to cut through that. But for just now today, I wanted to show you what tools you're going to need. And when I come back and show you tomorrow or the next day, I'll show you exactly how to cut that out and how to fix it. You are also going to need a couple of scrap pieces of wood. Now, what you can use for that, if you have nothing else, is you can use paint sticks. Paint sticks you'll be able to use. I'm in the shop. There's scrap pieces of wood all over the place. So I can use that. And again, when I get called, I always have scrap to use. But I'm going to keep the cost down. I'm going to show you how to do it very economically so that you can do it relatively quickly. And hopefully, again, at the end of the day, get your deposit money back so you're not losing tons of money for a very little repair that I'm sure the homeowner is going to charge, or the landlord is going to charge you outrageous amounts of money, even though he can either do it himself for $30 or $40 or pay somebody, you know, $150, $200, and he'll probably keep half of your deposit, which could be up to $1,000 for that. Okay, so again, I will talk to you soon, and we will see you later. Stay well, stay safe, stay away. Things are getting better. Stay strong, stay away. Things are getting better. See you soon. Bye.